Hi, I'm Dr. Adeline Tang from University of Malaysia Sabah. This video clip is to explain Unit 11, Entrepreneurship Ethics in the course Fundamentals of Entrepreneurial Acculturation. This is the last unit in this course. The learning outcome of this Unit 11 is first to understand the meaning and main principles of ethics, interpret the importance of ethics in business, and understand the social responsibility of entrepreneurial today. So first of all, we need to understand what do you mean by ethics. Here, ethics is to tell us is a set of principles that telling us what is right and what is wrong in the society, in the country, in the environment. So it really depends on the culture and the beliefs of the people in that society. When we talk about ethics, at the same time, we must understand the law itself. Right? Law and ethics, they are working together to help to control business activities. Ethics is about what is right or wrong, like I say. What is right or wrong in the to do in that society, to do in that environment. But at the same time, ethics are dynamic. It might be changing by itself due to the changes in environment of society. And it is set by the society with a common interest, and this is subjective, subject to human interpretation. You can interpret it different ways sometimes. But for law, law is legal. It's telling you what is right legally and illegal, something that we should not do. If you did something illegal, then you'll be caught, and then you will be penalty either by put into the jail or you have to pay the some ransom or summon or whatever. And law is static. It means that it will not change by itself. It will only change if the government feel that is needed to change. So government will determine what are the law we are doing, we are facing at the same time. This law must be subjective, must be remain the same, imposed to everybody in the same society. So legal and ethical are relatively important. They control the business activities. Next, we will look at how the legal environment, the law, influence our business. The law will govern the business systems. They will govern the business in doing. For example, law affect the business commerce, for example, about customer safety, consumer safety. We have to ensure that the product is safe to be consumed. Okay, environment protection, protect the environment against pollution or purposely polluted the environment, whatever. And then at the same time also, this law will create business opportunity to the organization. For example, during the MCR, the government wanted everybody to stay at home and try to purchase your goods and services through the online business. And at the same time trying to use e-wallet. All these are the governing that affect the business environment. So the business will find an opportunity from what happened during that environment. For example, online business, for example, e-wallet. All these are the opportunity. And at the same time, the law will affect the business occupations or the occupations of people. For example, what type of occupational qualification require, the diversity of employees, the employee's health and safetyness. This is to protect the employee in the organization. And at the same time, the law also affect the setting up of the business organization to protect the organization as well as to protect the employee in the organization. For example, the type of companies that have the bankruptcy rules, the patents and rights, trademarks. All this is to protect the intellectual property of the business. So it's very important we have to understand what is happening or what are the rules or law that a country observe when we do business in that country. So these are some of the, and at the same time, we know some there are some of the ethical rules. Or we call it rules for ethical decision making. First, utility rule. Utility rule is an ethical decision to produce the greatest good for the greatest number of people. So we are trying to do the best for most people, not for a small group of people. And at the same time, bear in mind, we have this moral right rules. Unethical decision should maintain and protect the fundamental rights and privilege of people. For example, the right of people to speak about themselves, the right of people to use the safe product. This is important. Justice rule. Unethical decisions should distribute benefits and should not harm people in a fair, equitable, impartial manner. That means everybody has the same right to use the product, provided they have the amount of money to pay for that services. And practical rule, unethical decisions should be one that a manager has no hesitation to communicate to people outside the company, because the typical person in a society would think the decision is acceptable. So these are the rules for making decision. So the main principles of ethical, we can see in simple is to be fair to everybody, to be responsible to the employee, to be to the environment, to the customers, and to the stakeholders. To be honest in doing the business, trustworthy is so important, and care for the right of other people. So when we talk about ethics, you can look at some example here. For example, this ethics in online business. You can see here, this is one of the example here. You can press the link for the details. Also, you can see there are different ethics you can observe when you are doing different business. For example, for the groceries, okay, the buying and sales of goods and necessities. So there are different ethics that you have to observe. Also, you can see when we are property agent, then it might be different type of ethics that we have to observe. And remember, when we have go through the MCO, now we are in the third stage. So what we are facing now is we have to take care of our customers. As a businessman, we also have to bear in mind, we have to make sure our workers are safe, because everybody is in the threat of pandemic. So we have to be careful. We have to always think, what can we do extra to protect ourselves, our employees, and at the same time to protect our customers. This is what we have to think now as a businessman. The importance of ethics here. First, you can see ethics can create confidence among the customers. So customer will tend to trust us more if they know that this company has a good ethics, then they will be more confident with the products that selling by us. Then very likely we will have a better relationship with the supplier as well, because the supplier will also trust us as a company with good ethics. And at the same time, the workers will be happy to work for us, and then they will do more for the company. And at the same time, we can attract investment from this, from our ethical background. Investors willing to invest more in this sort of companies and ensure the company survive in the long run, because customers, employees, workers, suppliers, even shareholders are willing to work together with this kind of company. So it will really help the company to survive in the long run. Besides, when we talk about ethics, we should understand what to mean by social responsibility. Social responsibility is an organization responsibility to the society. This normally comes with combined by the law, but at the same time, the company is willing to do extra miles for the stakeholders, for the employees, for the workers, for everybody in the society. For example, they will do extra for controlling the pollution, reduce the pollution, and some companies willing to do extra recycling efforts to reduce the waste in the use of, to increase the use of recyclable products, reduce the waste, and so on. And at the same time, energy is very important sources. We are facing a world that with reduced energy, so the company has to think of ways to increase the energy efficiency. This is very important to reduce the use of energy, especially petroleum, as petroleum is reducing. So the company can suggest like such as energy saving programs, for example, carpools, provided bus for the workers to come to work together to reduce the use of petrol and so on. And at the same time, in terms of human resources, it's very important to be responsible for the workers' health and safety to ensure that the workers are always health and safety to provide the best services to the company. And at the same time, providing training and development to the employees are very important to ensure that the employees will get better and improve. And another common facilities provided by big organizations actually is the daycare services provided by parents working in the organization. So this is to help the parents to take care of the kids and make sure they are happy working in that company without worrying their own children at home. And last will be the community. Okay, we help the community effort. For example, we give donations. Companies can give donations, sponsorship, support, and cooperation to the society. All this will help to improve the society as a whole, and it also shows that the company is responsible, is a responsible organization. They are willing to help out the community as a whole. You can have refers to the newspaper for more news on business ethics. It will be helpful for a company to decide what type of ethics expected by the government, by the stakeholders, by the customers, and they should be able to do better. Thank you for watching this video clip. Okay, this is the last video clip, and then I hope you enjoy this series of video clips. Please refer to my Smart Tree website for the details. And for this slide, I uploaded in the Schoology account. The access code is here. You also need to edit your profile here at the www.goecommerce.my. Okay, so thank you for watching. And then remember, for this week, this is week 12 for my MPK students. You need to watch the two video clips for Unit 10 and Unit 11, and also answer the quiz. The quiz will carry marks for your final. Okay, will carry mark for your final. So please go to my Schoology accounts to do the quiz in this week. Thank you for watching.